The guy you're about to meet is the most sought-after music producer on the planet and the man behind the success of some of the world's biggest artists.
He's written and produced for Amy Winehouse, Adele, Bruno Mars, Lady Gaga. He's won 2 Grammys, a Golden Globe, even an Oscar. And now, for the first time on his new album, he's ready to tell his own story.
Mark, it's lovely to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too.
Late Night Feelings is a really impressive record. It's a change for you though, not just musically, but personally. Do you feel that you were hiding parts of yourself before?
Sure, when I look at it, you know, my other records, I work with people who are pretty like honest and emotionally vulnerable, like open book in their music. But for some reason, in my own music, I've always been like, well, I'm the DJ. Like, I make serious music over here with these people. And then when I make my own records, it should just be like fluffy and fun. So I guess this is the first record where every time I go to the studio, it was like the only thing that came out that really meant anything would have a little layer of like emotional depth.
What were you scared of
before? I had grown up like my entire sort of adult life, like not really able to deal with like conveying my emotions, just like in life, let alone music. Going through like a really kind of like life altering experience suddenly was like, oh fuck, like I kind of like stirred the beast a little bit. And then so it makes sense that suddenly that was like filtering into the music.
What's really changed you?
I mean, obviously the breakup, that's the most like kind of obvious thing, the breakup of my marriage. Like, you know, there was kind of like when we first broke up, I did the immature thing of instead of kind of like dealing with it, you're just like going out and drink, you're in rebound relationships. I kind of came out and I was like, all right, like I can't look at this string of failed relationships in my life and be so immature to be like, oh, I just met the wrong person, I'm unlucky in love. Any therapist will tell you all this shit leads to your childhood. You go explore that. And it's like, it becomes like a process of like discovery. There's not ever one moment that you're kind of healed and you're like, okay, I've gotten over it. But the minute you like, you can kind of recognize it and be honest with yourself, like that's probably was the time that I started to like get this access to this other music that was maybe deeper than what I dealt with before. And I kind of like woke up one morning and was like, okay, like this has been long enough, I need to deal with what I'm going through. And that's sort of like about the time that I met Miley, we did Nothing Breaks. The record really like hit a stride.
What were you struggling with the most emotionally?
I don't want to turn this into a therapy session, but into something.
Let's turn it into a therapy session. Let's get deep.
Okay, cool. I actually had to wake up at 7 a.m. to FaceTime with my therapist who lives in Miami this morning. That's why I'm a little tired. But I think the thing is that, like, the way that I grew up, I probably wouldn't have even thought to put my emotions into my music because I wasn't even, like, really that honest with my emotions in fucking life, you know?
Were you a troubled kid?
I wasn't a troubled kid. I just grew up like in a household that was like a troubled household, you know? So there was like a lot of like, you know, my parents were kind of like probably got married too young. They liked to party, you know, put the rest of it together.
I guess you're really letting us in now like never before.
Right.
How does it feel for you now to be a little more vulnerable?
I think it feels pretty great because like the minute that you can start kind of being honest as well, there's like this huge relief. I think I've just struggled it, like never really accessed it up to now. And then like once you sort of open the floodgates, it's this kind of wonderful thing. I mean, I'm not saying like every piece of music I'm gonna make from now on is like super confessional, but just like trying to like be a better person. You get better music out of it.
Performing the title track from his new album, Late Night Feelings, featuring Leaky Lee. Ladies and gentlemen, Mark Ronson.
Being, you know, at the top of your game, are there moments where you just feel super overwhelmed, and how do you deal with that feeling?
I think I used to. I used to have like crazy anxiety attacks and this thing like since I was like 14. But for the most part, I feel like, I mean, it's so cliche, but like you move to LA, you learn fucking meditation, you go hiking, some of it's super corny, like reading fucking self-help books and then Eastern philosophy.
You're reading self-help books?
Yeah.
What are you reading?
Like I have like this in my bookshelf at home, like all like these cool art books and photography books and like the Beastie Boys, and there's like a hidden drawer with like things like with names like Hold Me Tight.
I've got them too, man, it's all good. We've all got a few hidden self-help books.
I mean, all these books is just like kind of like teach you about your brain and how it works, and you're just like, oh, okay, like I'm not a fucking freak, I'm just like everybody else and this is what's happening right now. You know, I'm 43, like I'm trying to like break patterns I've had my whole life. I do want a family one day, I want all this stuff. So like I realized to do that, like I gotta kind of like fix something about the way I deal with feelings, relationships, other people, whatever it is. Like you have to look at the fucking man in the mirror.
When you get up now in the morning and you look in the mirror, are you happy with the man you see?
Well, I've been going to the gym a lot, so I feel pretty good about that.
I don't mean physically.
No, I know. yeah, I think so. Like, I mean, you always know you can improve and work and whatever.
Are you still heartbroken?
No. I don't think you ever fully heal 100%, right? But you, like, learn to, like, sort of like triumphantly kind of like move on from this thing and learn from it, and if you make music or art you can use it and put it into that or whatever it is. So like the good thing is like you're not maybe ever fully healed, but like the scars can like make and define you and kind of like build you up in a way. Like, you know, scar tissue is like harder than skin tissue. So it sounds so deep. I was like quoting Anthony Kiedis, like what the fuck's going on?
It's beautiful. But
we went deep.
Yeah, definitely. I like to go deep.
Yeah, it's cool.
So nice to chat to you, Mark. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much. Cool.
Hi, I'm Jan Fran. If you like that video, check out another one from the feed. And don't forget to like and subscribe.